Alright, so we're ready to create our cockpit now. All I'm going to do is hit extrude, move these up a little bit, and go into my side view and start to round these out. Just going to follow the contours of my form, first getting that outside edge in place, and then worrying about everything else. So I'm just getting those other vertices out of the way. And now I can come back in with my second row and start to round that out so it creates the essentially similar curvature to what we have on the outside edge. I also want to do this from my perspective view because it's, I think, a little bit easier to do from perspective and actually going into the ortho and seeing from the front. And I'm going to just start to narrow this together piece by piece to help create a more rounded form. Doing one at a time. Let's get maybe these first three here and pull these up a little bit more to change that angle. And so we've got a little shading crease around this edge. Let's go in with insert edge loop. Cut an edge loop right along that center, scale it in with our blue axis, and actually push it down, which is going to create a little dip right around that cockpit. So that when I go in, choose normals, soften edge, I've got a nice little shading crease that I can follow along the side of the form. Of course, my big problem as before, I delete out one side, is that you can see I've got interior faces. So it's going to be my continuous task to make sure I get rid of any of these interior faces. You don't want them inside your model because they're going to pose problems when we try and sew this up. I'll do a edit duplicate special again. And we've got a pretty nice looking form. I'm going to go down to the bottom now. Let me turn off show grid just so we can see this a little bit better. Instead of leaving this hanging down here, like I said, I'm actually going to move this back up and extrude down to create that bottom piece. I'm going to create this selection from these rows of faces. Actually, you know what? I don't think I want that last one. And I'm just going to hit extrude with those three, grab the move tool right away, and bring this downward. Be careful of that center line, because again, we're going to have to fix this in just a bit. And I'm going to try and trace this right off of my image plane yet again. Piece by piece. And one of the sort of challenging things with this sometimes is the fact that you have all these overlapping vertices. It becomes very, very hard to see what you're actually looking at in some cases. You just have to be really on top of your game and really know what you're looking at as much as you can. You don't really want to make sure that you're losing track of your vertices, which can become very easy to do when you're looking straight through a model in wireframe, as we see here. Well, I've got this little section. You'll notice that my front profile is very square, and the way I've created it, it's kind of more of a peaked down shape. So I'm going to try and take these bottom three, just these bottom three, flatten them out in each of my axes, and try and bring them down so that they work. Maybe I'll round out just that front one. I'll bring up that bottom edge just a little bit as well. To create a cut along this, well, I'm going to go in, choose Edit Mesh, insert an edge loop, just like before, and I'm going to scale together just a little bit and tuck it just up inside. And that's going to give me the shading crease that I'm after once I smooth this out or soften this out. going to manipulate some of these vertices just a little bit. Now, this is actually a little air intake down here. And again, before I actually deal with this, I'm actually going to cut off one side of the model, soften my edges, and get rid of these interior faces, which have continuously sort of plagued our project. Well, I want to create an air intake that goes all the way back through the model. So what I'm going to do here is select my front face and hit extrude, bringing it together into an additional edge loop. Since it's not going to be two, I'm going to get rid of this side one. And using W for the move tool and X for snap to grid, I'm going to snap these back to the center. Now I can take this additional new face and extrude this all the way back through the model. Well, like I said before, I don't need any interior faces, so I'm going to get rid of some of these. I'll even get rid of the back face here because we're going to try and connect this up in just a second. You can see I've got a pretty nice little intake going all the way back through, and I can even narrow out the form there so it's hard to see straight through. To connect these edges, what we're going to do is we're going to use a new tool called the Append Polygon tool, which allows me to connect any gaps that I've created. What I'm going to do is go to Edit Mesh and choose Append Polygon tool. I'm going to click from this open edge to the air intake, giving me a new pink colored face, which is a potential face. When I have it selected, I'll hit enter, and it will actually create a new face for me. I'm going to hit Y on the keyboard, which will bring back the last tool, or I could just go to Edit Mesh and choose Append Polygon. Click from one edge to the other, always trying to create quads, four-sided faces, and then hit enter. Y to bring back the last tool, and I'll click across again to wrap this up, and I'll have one final edge. I'll take my vertices and move them a little bit closer along this back end so there's not so much of a bevel here.